Okay, so this lecture will be about the notion of stability, which has already been mentioned here by Blum in the first lecture, which is also slightly related to Spearman lecture. So it's based on a joint work with Nati Linial. And we'll start with a rather informal definition of what is stability and a motivation for this notion. So here is the informal definition. We say that an instance is stable if an instance for an optimization problem is stable if the point where the optimum is obtained does not change upon a small perturbation. In other words, if we move the instance a bit, the configuration for which the optimum is obtained does not change at all. And our main question of interest is the following question: are there efficient algorithms for NP-hard optimization problems that correctly solve all sufficiently stable instances? Okay, so there are many reasons to study stable instances. And maybe the most convincing one is clustering problem. So we will consider clustering problems of the following kind. The input is a set of objects which we denote by x, and a dissimilarity function d, such that d of xy is the distance or the dissimilarity between the object x and the object y. And we do not assume that d is a metric or any other restriction on d. And the output is an optimal clustering in some sense, when a clustering is considered good if a similar object or close object are classified into the same cluster. For example, we wish to find a cut, a partition of X into two sets, S and its complements, that maximize the sum of distances between points that are classified into opposite sides of the cuts. Okay, so for these problems, we can now define precisely what we mean by stability. So we say that an instance is stable if the point where the optimum is obtained does not change upon a small perturbation. So the first step will be to define what is a perturbation. So we say that an instance x d tag is a gamma perturbation of another instance x d if for every entry, for every pair of points x y, d tag of x y is between 1 over square root of gamma times d x y to square root of gamma times d x y. That is, if we get an object x d, in order to generate a gamma perturbation of it, we are allowed to multiply each entry dxy by a number between 1 and gamma. Okay, so now we can define what is a stable instance, and we say that an instance xd is gamma stable if its optimal clustering is the same as the optimal clustering of all of its gamma perturbation. Okay, so why are we interested so much in stable instances? So our main claim, maybe slightly exaggerated, is that for clustering problems, we are only interested in stable instances. And I'll try to justify this claim. Well, the first reason is that in clustering problem, we are interested in instances where there is a clustering that is evidently a correct clustering, that is evident that it is really a partition of the data into two sets that each set have something is common. And this evidence is captured, among other things, by stability. That is, if we move the points a bit, the optimal clustering should not be changed. So this is the main reason why we think that for clustering problem, we are only interested in stable instances. And another reason is that we are not given the actual dissimilarity function, because they might not be a dissimilarity function, or maybe it is hard to measure it. So the real dissimilarity function is a perturbation of the dissimilarity function we obtain. And We are interested in cases where the solution of the instance we obtain is the same as the real perturbed instance. Okay, so hopefully I motivated you enough to study stable instances. And in the next part of the talk, we will see some results and proof techniques obtained for this notion. So we will start with a result of about K-medians, K-means, and K-clusters, and other center-based clustering problems. And we will focus on K-medians for simplicity, but similar results also for K-means. Okay, so here the input is endpoint metric space XD, and I emphasize that now we do assume that D is a metric. And the output is a set of centers, a set of K-centers, C1 to CK, that might be in X and might be in some ambient space, that minimizes the sum of distances between each point in X to its center, where the center of a point is the point in C that is closest to this point. Okay, so here we have a nice result by Awasthi-Blum and Sheffet, claiming that there is an efficient algorithm for free stable instances for K-median. It's also true for K-means. And I'll try to describe a sketch of the proof. So the first step is to show that free stability entails that every point is three times closer to its own center than to the other centers. And using this property, it is possible to show that the single linkage process plus some processing entails the optimal solution of K-medians, where a single linkage process is the following process. We start with n clusters, each containing a single point, and at each step, we merge the two closest clusters, where the distance between two clusters is the minimal distance between two points, the first in the first cluster and the second in the other cluster. So again, we start with n cluster. At each step, we merge the two closest clusters. And at the end, we finish after n minus one steps with one cluster containing all the space. So using the first property, it can be shown that every cluster in the optimal solution for K-medians is obtained as a cluster in one of the steps. And using some dynamic programming, and it can be shown that the optimal clustering can be extracted. Okay, so our next result is about metric max cut. So here again, the input is an endpoint metric space, XD, and the output is a cut, a partition of X into two sets, S and its complement, that maximize the sum of distances between pairs of points that are classified into opposite sides of the cut. So here we have a rather strong theorem claiming the following, that for every epsilon greater than zero, there is an efficient algorithm that correctly solves all 1 plus epsilon stable instances for metric max cut. And this is, in some sense, the best we can hope for, because this problem is NP-out, so we know that one stable instance cannot be solved. I mean, every instance is one stable, and we know that we can solve these instances, so this result is optimal in some sense. And I'll describe its proof, which is rather simple. We start by sampling log n points, x1 to xl, according to some distribution, not the uniform distribution. And then we show that with high probability there is a partition of the sample points into two sets A and its complement that induces the optimal cut, where the cut induced by the partition A and its complement is the following cut. On one side, we put all the points that are on average closer to A, and on the other side, we put all the points that are on average closer to the complement of A. And we show that with high probability, the optimal cut is of this form. And since we have only sampled log n points, we can iterate over all the cut of this kind and find the optimal one. So this proves the theorem. Okay, so we are almost finished. In the last slide, I'll talk about future work we intend to do, and we intend to work on MaxCat in general, not the metric version that I mentioned before. So far, we have assumed rather strong restriction on the dissimilarity function D. Specifically, we assume that D is a metric. It is enough to assume that D is a Lifshitz, but we can't throw away this assumption. And without this restriction, we need n over log n stability to design efficient algorithm for MaxCat, which is a rather large amount of stability that is not always, it's usually not reasonable to assume in practice. However, we do conjecture that there exists some constant gamma star such that there is an efficient algorithm that correctly solves all gamma star instances of MaxCat, which is the problem we're currently working on.
Sorry, when you say we need that stability,
okay, so we need the stability.
That's all we know how to prove right now?
That is all in order to prove. We don't have a hardness result, only rather weak hardness result, something like that 1 plus 1 over n stability does not suffice us, but nothing stronger than that, and we only know to prove n over log. We only know to design an algorithm that correctly solves all n over log n stable instances. Or at least that's the best we know to prove for this algorithm. Okay, so I'll finish here.
Okay,
any questions?